Canada is the country in many things, many places. It's the country in many races, many people. No matter where we live, no matter where our place is, Canada is waiting for you. Today we're going to learn about second condition. The second condition is used to talk about impossible situations. For example, if we were in London today, we would be able to go to a concert in Hyde Park. If I had millions of dollars, I'd give a lot to charity. If there were no hungry people in this world, it would be a much better place. If everyone had clean water to drink, there would be a lot less disease. Know that after I, he, she, or it, we often use the subjunctive form were and not was. Some people think that were is the only correct form, but other people think was is equally correct. For example, if she were happy in her job, she wouldn't be looking for another one. If I live in Japan, I'd have sushi every day. If there were to enter our market, we'd have big problems. Note the form, if I were you, it is often used to give advice. For example, if I were you, I'd look for a new place to live. If I were you, I'd go back to school and get more qualifications. The second condition is also used to talk about unlikely situations. For example, if I went to China, I'd visit the Great Wall. If I was the president, I'd reduce taxes. If you were in my position, you'd understand. Note that the choice between the first and second condition, it is often a question of the speaker's attitude rather than of facts. Compare these examples. Although these things are possible. Peter doesn't. Otto says, if I win the lottery, I'll buy a big house. Peter says, if I won the lottery, I'd buy a big house. Otto says, if I get promoted, I'll throw a big party. Peter says, if I got promoted, I'd throw a big party. Otto says, if my team win the cup, I'll buy champagne for everybody. Peter says, if my team won the cup, I'd buy champagne for everybody. Know that the if clause can contain the past simple or the past continuous. For example, if I was still working in Brighton, I would commute by train. If she were coming, she would be here by now. If they were thinking of selling, I would want to buy. Note that may clause can contain would, could, or might. For example, if I had the chance to do it again, I would do it differently. If we met up for lunch, we could go to that new restaurant. If I spoke to him directly, I might be able to persuade him. Also note that sometimes the if clause is implied rather than spoken. For example, what would I do without you if you weren't here? Where would I get one at this time of night if I wanted one? He wouldn't agree if I ask him. Which one is the correct form of the second condition? One, I strongly recommend that if you work today. Two, should your friend check the keys before? If we will have time. Three, we should pay for the coffee when they gave us a chance. Four, if they were thirsty, she would bring to us a bottle of water. The answer is number four. If they were thirsty, she would bring to us a bottle of water. The action already passed, were simple past. Would, it implies an impossible situation. Number one, I strongly recommend that if you work today, it is not an impossible action. Two, should your friend check the keys before? If we will have time? It is not an impossible or unlikely action. Three, we should pay for the coffee when they gave us a chance. Pay is present action and an advice. Gave is the past simple. Explore the website of Canada Smart Mind. You can enjoy yourself, learn English, French, and the Canadian immigration process. Make a difference. That's it. Thanks so much for watching this video. See you again next time.